Everything here is brand new. We got all new bikes, all new equipment, all sorts of simulation equipment, driving, racing.
And that's just walking. You.
Yeah. Except the cafe's not open yet, which is really annoying.
I want the ice cream from there. Actually, this is ice cream.
I have no idea. No. But Jack's not gonna walk around and show you everything. Go. This is my prototype. Don't drop it. Okay, that was a quick tour. Daily update today. Jack, what are we going to do today?
What are we going to do tonight?
What are we going to do?
Oh, scene redesign, more transitions. Transitions pretty much fixed for the second scene. But again, we need to make sure that things connect really well with the first scene as well, with the first scene and the third scene actually. So that's one. Placing more doors, that's an easy one, but making the door look... making a door look fitting is a harder part of that equation. And then afterward, you might have to figure out a way to go back from, you know.
Might?
Either today or tomorrow, right? So we might do it today. Depends on how much the workflow is.
True. Yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, so right now we have one way of going forward. We don't know exactly how to go back yet. And thus, we need to figure out either a keyboard mapping or a hidden game, well, I call it game mechanism that will, you know, trigger the player to go back. And this is kind of difficult because when you're watching a movie, you don't want to see the controllers, but you need to access to its functionalities, right? So how do we make that intuitive is another question. You know, we might just make the controller fade out, like after. Yeah, make it transparent. But it's a model, though. Can you make it transparent that way? Well, I guess you could. You could change the material, right? You could change the material of the controller. But yeah, how do you make that intuitive? Is the question that every, you know, VR designer and VR maker actually has right now.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we could keep the controller inside. We have to think of something that fits in every single movie, like having it in your hand. Given that it's a controller, so it doesn't really matter. You can put it on the ground and you won't see anything.
No, I feel like it's better to... It's better to fade out.
What's the point of fading out?
Because I'll show it, will be like, map it, right? Tell you what button does what, and then it fades out. And then when you press a button, it comes back. It's like a mouse. When you move it, it comes back, right? If you don't touch it during video play, it fades out. It's gone.
You mean the instructions. I thought you meant the controller. The controller has to be there, because if they put it down, they need to be able to find the controller.
No, well...
The thing is, they're putting it on the ground. How are you expecting to find it again if it's staying?
But that's the thing, though. It's a 360 movie, and the controller actually destroys the immersions, right?
No, the thing is, if you can't see your hand in any sort of VR experience, it doesn't feel as good. I actually like the controller there.
Oh, so you want it to be there.
I do want the controller there. It feels a lot more natural when you can see your hands. Yeah.
Okay, but we need to destroy most, or we need to disable most of the controller's functionalities.
Right. No trigger?
Well, actually, triggers are minor.
No, we got rid of the shooting.
Shooting is definitely not supposed to be there. And you need a button. Maybe map it to the button.
Yeah, maybe.
Right? It makes sense, right? Left click, right click. Right? Left click, right click, middle click.
Yeah, we'll see. I almost want to have like a permanent back button here, and then you use the other hand to click on the back button. I kind of almost want to have it that way. So it's not as easily, because like people click by accident all the time, so yeah, you know? But this, that motion is deliberate. So instead of a back button, you know, like we had before, we have it on hand, use the other hand to trigger it. That's what I'm doing.
So what would that be is, would that be a collider? You collide with it, and then depending on that, you do a, then you do a laser pointer in a certain direction. And then that's going
to
be a UI element on your left hand.
Yeah. You have a UI element on your left hand.
And a laser pointer on the right.
Yeah.
Yes.
I suppose you could have just a collider that collides with the button and it loads the bar like you always have.
Collider collides with the button.
Yeah. As, you know, on trigger enter, it starts loading. After 3 seconds, it takes you back. Leave it.
But that's not intuitive, though.
Why is it not? You're used to that button when you select it. Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah, like that.
You have to teach people how to do it because there's nobody right now.
No, your controller is exactly the same looking as when you chose the film, right?
Right.
You press the play button. The play button looks the same as the back button. Your controller looks the same. Now that you just put it together just like how you did it always. It's very intuitive. How did you get into the film?
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah. Right?
So, button click will enable the UI, and then putting it together will trigger it to go back.
Yeah.
And show complexities.
The only thing that you have to track is the button's here. When you move the hand like that, it's kind of weird. But that's the only discontinuity that I can imagine right now. Everything else is very intuitive. You hold it like this, everything's intuitive. Unless you're doing that. But then the collider's a box, so it shouldn't matter. It's just the way it looks, so I don't think that'll help. Right?
Or we could just have a button, display button in front of. Once you click it, display a button from people, and then you have to touch it. Just touch it once. You don't have, like.
No, definitely not.
Why not?
Because we haven't introduced that UI anywhere else.
You haven't introduced clicking anywhere else, so.
There is no clicking.
There is clicking.
How is there a clicking?
How do you display that? When the two things get close enough?
Yeah.
So when they move to
When the collider collides.
When the two controller collide.
When X on trigger collide, or not trigger, sorry, on, just collide, on it, collision enter, right?
Because the two controllers are
similar. Yeah. Okay. So one controller, imagine how we're doing swim selection, right? You click, now,
First of all, that defeats the purpose that we use additional colliders for keyboard.
What do you mean?
Remember, I had to put in a sphere explicitly for keyboard input, right? So if we then, because I want to avoid putting colliders on the controller.
No, it's not on the controller. The controller still has the same orb. It's exactly the same looking as when you're selecting the film. When you press the play button, it's exactly the same thing. Exactly the
same. So you don't want to...
It's just nice in here. Too lazy to go upstairs right now.
So you don't want to actually disable the spheres once you're watching them.
No, so as you take up the controller, it looks exactly the same. Nothing changes except for this hand.
Yes.
Yeah.
How do you want to trigger back then?
No, so once you're entering the film, right? So
right.
When you select it,
right.
That controller already has the orb.
Right.
That doesn't change in the film. It's there.
Oh, okay.
Right? So it's still the same thing. The only thing that changes is on your left hand now, or right hand depending on how you're holding it, there's a back button, right? The same back button that you see on the selection menu, right? And all you're gonna do is take one hand and press the button like you did when you select play. So it's very intuitive, nothing changed. Everything looks the same. The
Not
UI is
pressing,
very
but just both.
You just put
pressing,
it, well, the same damn thing.
Pressing,
right?
Pressing in proximity, yes.
Yeah, it's the same thing, nothing changed.
So you always see the back button?
Yeah. Trust me, no one will notice.
Okay then.
Yeah, no one will notice.
Proceed. But at least give it a try.
No one will notice.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's
right. Anything else we want to talk about?
No, I think that's it. That's probably one of the things we want
to see working just right now. Like,
right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because we need to be able to go back and forth, and make sure that's smooth. Because that's one of the key elements.
Right, so how about from second scene to the first scene?
Second scene to the first scene, like, it's less important right now.
Okay, don't worry about it.
We do that, that's very easy. We just have to think of a way to trigger it. You're just calling a scene. Okay, wait, no, you gotta recall it. Okay.
Well, you're just calling a scene, to be honest.
No, we
didn't
think about how to,
what do we load, what do we download, from the buffer, and all that.
When
we have to think about the back end right now.
What do you load?
You go in there, you watch the film, it's already downloaded, right?
Right.
So we go back to the first scene. Should we erase it? Because now we're going to assume that they're going to go to a different
door. Well, no, it's saved 2DS.
I know, but we should... No, we're talking about if we're loading from the cloud right now.
Yeah, loading from the cloud, right. You're always saving it to the stream asset.
So should we delete it now because it's wasting memory? Because we said, okay, he's watched it. I don't really think he's going to watch it again. He's going back to the first scene. Therefore, most likely he wants to go through a different door. So should we delete it? Yeah. Yeah. What do you need?
Cat 5. No Cat 5. No, it's not. No, you don't have Cat 5. I mean connection, right?
Oh, no.
Okay, that's fine.
What do you need?
I need to be on the network first.
Well, finally, we have a calf that's better than Tencent's calf. So, I mean, this is definitely
it's
better
bright.
Than.
No way. Yeah. So again, we should delete it as we load the first scene, because we don't want to waste space.
But what if the user wants to download it while watching something else, right?
Well, you can choose to download.
Oh, you mean streaming?
If you download, the thing is like. Ideally, I don't want anything downloaded. I want it all streamed.
You can cache it for a while before you... you can cache it and then
The thing is, let's say we watch 10 films in scene 2, right? And now you're calling scene 1. You have 10 things. That's 10 gigabytes.
You're just not downloading. You stop download stream. You cache it for now. Next time they log it in,
I was talking about if you're saying you're downloading it and then watching it later.
Yeah.
So if I download it, I have to download 10 films at once. First of all, my entire internet is going to be dead.
Crash,
right? So how do we work out that flow? How do we make sure?
Can our software be running in the background? You can't do that?
You can run software in the background, right? But I don't know what else you can do.
But we need to cache it in a very convenient manner, right?
Yeah.
What's that word? So what DNS is
But yeah, so I'm thinking, you can create a.
Can I remove your DNS?
Yeah, go ahead. Doesn't matter. So.
No, it doesn't make sense. It's default. Why would they even leave this DNS? That's not the sense.
Should we put a cap on download? There should be a cap on download. There should be a cap on the queue.
Yeah.
So every time you download something, it's in a queue, right?
Yeah.
Hit two things, there's two items in a queue. We should make a cap on that queue.
Well, you could download a zillion things. Only one thing gets downloaded at a time, right?
Right, so you put it in, you're right. So you
you're not stimulously downloading everything.
Right.
Or simultaneously
downloading I understand that part, but what we have to figure out is how do we remove things from the queue as well, because that queue is not accessible by clients. Right? We press the download button and start downloading. How do we remove things from the download button so they can cancel download? We need to put a button there. So then now we're thinking, okay, because we have a play button right now, right? We have a play and we go back, right? So should we have a download? And that download turns into a cancel. That's what I'm thinking.
That's a bit too far.
No, because now I'm thinking, we're calling the first scene, right? Should this entire loaded door be kind of reverted back to this thing?
No.
Clear a queue.
I don't think so. It's just downloading, right? If the users don't want to do that, they do it themselves.
Okay.
It's their decision.
That makes it.
You don't want to make the decision. You don't want to make the decision overly easy for people, because then you might be assuming too much. You're getting a loop of just thinking about what the user wants to do, right? But
that's your point.
But that's different people have different behaviors. If I don't
want
to.
That's what we're testing. We need to choose one and test.
But that's much down the road. Suddenly,
do you have command
prompts
here? What should I use for command prompts?
Right?
Command prompts.
A command prompt.
Oh, command prompt?
Command prompts for Android.
Bash. Bash.
Android?
For Android.
It's actually going out, right?
It's fine.
It's route,
yeah.
Right?
Android.
No worries, but it's actually tracing, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is slow.
It takes forever, right?
Yes, yeah.
It'll take a while.
But DNS is strange, right? They give you a strange DNS.
Yeah, I actually don't know the DNS that it gives. That looks...
Wait, why do you need to connect to a domain name server? Right?
He's trying to set... Is this place running on... I don't even know what server this place is running on.
Why do you need a server for this place?
Because how would you connect to...
There's stuff, right?
Yeah.
We only need internet, don't we?
No, I don't think so. What does
Emacs
use? Emacs
you have to change your DNS data, okay?
Yeah, I figured.
Okay, I'll fuck you up. Okay.
I figured I'll fix it later.
So you actually need to... Well, you need to connect to server.
Yeah. I mean, I wonder how this works.
Okay.
I wonder how this... I don't know the networks behind it.
I don't know what Emacs is, but I'll find out soon enough when I look at what
happened. Okay. So they have local
I can also
domain. Oh, wait, are we accessing their database? Is that why... we don't need names.
Well, I don't know how Emacs works, but I'm curious.
Okay.
Yeah, but anyways, I think that's something we should figure out. Like, when we call the first scene. Because, like, it gets overly... Watch them go in this door, go out that door, go in another door, go back this door. Our database is done. Like, an order of things, the queues, like, where is it pipeline to? Like, that's going to be so messy. I already see a nightmare at this front.
Well, don't we just have a queue if you don't touch anything?
Yeah,
right?
But I really don't like... For example, how Steam does it.
Are you talking about downloading stream or talking about...
Downloading stream, yeah.
Steam does a pretty good job,
actually. I really hate that.
Why?
First of all, it's a queue. One, two, three, four, and then, like, it gets really messy. I'm like, okay, now this downloading is, like... So, like, sometimes I'm like, okay, what if I want to download this one first, drag it up, but, like, it doesn't do that. It just crashes. Every single time I try to switch it, it crashes.
So you pause the one, and then you start downloading.
Right. So now think about it. In order for you to go cancel one, let's say
you don't cancel, you pause.
No, even pause or cancel, imagine I have 10 films downloading. Now I'm going to go into it, click the pause, go back out, click another film, press the cancel, press the pause or whatever it is. And like you have to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth through the exact same layer over and over again in order for that to work.
Well,
so there needs to be a garbage collector that somehow just knows. Like we need some kind of way to predict it. That's what I'm saying.
You can't, though.
What do you mean?
The user might want that, like, just for downloads, right?
So the thing, like, the user might, but what's the probability of that happening? We need to know.
Well, the thing is, if the probability of that happens, like, if it happens way too often, or, sorry, not way too often, if it happens once, you're going to destroy your user immersion, like,
just
will
once.
Not be happy.
We don't care about every single person, right?
Well, the thing
we
is...
We care about the majority to make our software run faster, cleaner for the majority. Right? Think about how they're going to use this. Like there's no point building for everybody because you're just gonna have a system that's too bulky. Right?
I'm saying otherwise.
Why?
Because you might have large audience, right? Even pissing off like 10% or like 5%, 2%. Oh, that's a lot of people.
Your 95% is bigger. Way
right.
bigger.
Yeah.
It's magnitude, right? You don't care about the
But why 10%, well, why games can't do that is because 10% of people will be the people that talk shit about you. Or the 5% will be the people that
right.
talk shit about you.
But 95% of
will
people
not defend it.
If I'm YouTube,
won't defend it.
If 5% of the people talk shit about YouTube,
you're likely to have
5%.
Yeah, we'll start using it.
Yeah.
So it's
matter.
Gonna be a bad reputation. And we don't know how.
That doesn't
big
matter though. Who cares about your reputation with 5% of the people when 95% of people love them? Right?
That's
even if 10% love you and 90% don't care, that's fine too. Because why do we're not trying to gear for everybody, right? There's no point. That's like saying iPhone. There's a lot of crap about iPhones. They all go talk shit about iPhone. People still buy it.
No, I don't.
You don't.
Yeah.
But they make way more money that they don't care about you.
Right.
Right? So it doesn't matter.
No, but this is the thing though.
If
I
they try
still,
to build something for everybody, that's not happening.
I still don't think it's worth it going to the risks.
But
that you're taking a lot of risk.
Why? How
for
is,
that?
What,
because
what's the risk?
You don't know what the user wants.
Right, that's why we test it. We
could
it
test it
and then try it with 3,000 people on a testing platform
sure.
and then see what they think.
I mean, beta is that. Yeah,
like I think that's what we should do because I want to make this as fast as possible. As you know, like I do not want, I don't even want people downloading 10 things at once and pinging our servers. Bing, 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 bing,
right,
bing,
right,
bing,
right.
Bing, bing, bing. Let's say we have 200 users who are all downloading 10 film, and then that's already dead. I'm looking at this like infrastructure we have for cloud. That's gonna kill us. I'm already dead.
It's gonna be a lot of money.
We're already dead. Like, there's no, I don't even need to think about it. Like, cost wise, we're already dead. So, how are we going to do this? Like, that's something we need to figure out. How are we gonna do this? Like, should we limit it to streaming only and have a cap somewhere, or like, how is this gonna work?
Well, streaming, you're only downloading one at a time.
Yeah. So.
I mean, streaming is kind of reasonable. If they switch, you don't. Well, if they watch another one, you delete the old one.
Yeah.
It's not like
we
they
can
switch.
Catch whatever they streamed and then like come back. You know, I don't want. I don't know.
I don't think it's reasonable that way. Like, if they, YouTube doesn't cache anything, right? If you play a movie halfway, go back, they will go watch another video, and then after finishing it, come back and see the entire scene. Does it still save for you? It doesn't save. Right? I mean, at most, it save where you were.
Oh, no.
But
yeah,
it doesn't save.
But the thing
anything.
Is, like, if you click another video, that's, like, if you open another tab, it's still running.
Huh?
If you open another tab, it'll still be running.
We can't open a tab in VR.
I know. That's what I'm saying. How do we do that? Or do we want to do that? And I'm
Why
gonna,
do you want to do that?
I'm going to say we should cache some of it.
I mean, you should cache some of it. That's true. You should probably cache the time that the user was when they switched scene, right?
Yeah.
But
yeah, that's a good point.
How do you, like...
Wait, no. Then we need a button to start from the beginning again.
Sure. Or you don't cache it and just start
or
from
the beginning. Or you can choose, actually. So we need a process.
Or you just... you don't want to make interaction on the complex, then you start from the beginning of the world. Every time you quit. This is something.
Yeah. Anyways, that's...